we will give you a ticket. No different than what we did with taxis, you know, buying alcohol for kids at the hotels. No different than doing the stings to catch people selling tobacco and alcohol to the kids. Being at the bar is the same thing. I mean, those have been stings that have been very successful. We got to do that with the businesses that don't lock up their materials. You know, I'm not supportive of putting more laws because we already got plenty. Because we're not going to be able to enforce them. We can't enforce what we have, then, you know, those were my questions. How many times have we participated with the DA in persecuting somebody for doing a lot of, because some of them are the same people doing tagging and tagging over the same, if you take pictures of it, you see it's the same person, same artist, if you want to call them artists. You know, so you kind of know who's doing it. You just need to catch that one dude that's making all that mess. So in regards to the restitution, if you pay a fine, $100, that's an expensive business for some of those folks. So they say, I'll pay the $100 and I'll continue tagging. It's got to be something different. If you get to watch police cars for 8 hours for a whole week, you're going to remember not to do this again. There's got to be consequences for your behavior, and it can't be just your parents. Your parents need to be held accountable, but the kid, you got to put them to work. You got to put them, clean up the cemetery, clean up something. And you know what? They'll remember not to do that again. The whole thing with the parents, again, we got to work with the schools because that's where the parents gather. That's who has access to the parents. We don't. The city doesn't have as much access except when we send them bills. And that's not the proper way to communicate with somebody already. They're already pissed off about the bill. They don't want to listen to us about how to parent their kids. So we got to use the schools. We got to work the schools. We missed that opportunity all the time in working with the schools. So we got to do that. The access, we really, really got to crack down on the access because Ace Hardware, Orchard Supply, they don't lock up their stuff. I mean, they're the biggest violators of this law, and we let them get away with it. They're our neighbors and all that, but they're violating the law, so we got to go after them. It's no different than the Radio Shack selling scanners for the kids to listen to the police coming and being ahead of the police. We shouldn't be selling, we shouldn't allow people to sell scanners to kids. You know, if you can't buy two packets of cold medicine without somebody pulling your ID and putting you in a database, why can't we get people to be ID'd for just like cigarettes, to BID for markers, to BID for all this thing. We don't do that. So I think we just have the laws, we just haven't used them. You know, I mentioned at our retreat, there's a program in Gilroy's called BIP. It's Volunteers in Policing. And this is folks that are trained, that are trained by the police department, that work with the police department, and there's lots of them. There's about 20 or 30 of them. They're well-trained. They drive around and beat up old cars that the city has, and they actually do code enforcement. They've been trained to do code enforcement, and they do, and they are very active in the whole graffiti program. They still have issues with graffiti, but they're working at it. They have an arts context for kids. They have a whole bunch of programs, but it's the volunteers. So we need that. We need to get the volunteers, regardless if we had a lot of resources. It's good for neighbors to get involved. We got to create the opportunities for them to come and create the program. So I would suggest that we take a few folks from Salinas, including some residents, to go visit their BIP program that they have in Gilroy, so we can see what they do. It's a great program. I'm telling you, they even do CSI work, crime scene. They get trained and they do that themselves, so police officers don't have to be locked in for hours doing that stuff. Shifting the responsibility to homeowners especially, I won't support that. And this is not the time. When there was a lot of money, we should have done it. We didn't do it. This is the wrong time to put that. With businesses, we got to work with them. They didn't ask for the graffiti. It's being put on them. So we got to work with them. We got to figure out until things get better, we got to work with people. We can't just tax them to death and say, do this, or we're going to give you a ticket. We got to work with people. And there's plenty of warnings we can give and all that stuff. You know, so I can support all the things that have been said and by Councilman McShane, but also we got to work in this education. It is everybody's problem, but there is a solution. And Doug is right. We are ahead of a lot of the cities. When we had that big meeting, I mean, some of the cities are struggling. They're not even where the city of Salinas at. No one's at the situation where they're actually working with their garbage company and doing this kind of work. So we're ahead of them. We still have a problem, but the problem has existed for decades, for centuries, and it's political, it's gang, it's art, whatever you're going to call it. It's a problem. We just got to learn how to deal with it. And I think we can do that, especially if we do it locally and not involve the courts and everybody else, because I think that becomes more that becomes somebody else's problem and doesn't fix our local problem.
Okay, thank you, Sergio.
Remember too, guys, that these kids are acquiring paint online.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate that, but
Well, I'll just make my comments really quick. I think that the staff report recommends three things in particular: to amend the Chapter 14A of the City Code to clarify the responsibilities associated with the removal, develop the citywide program in the neighborhood, and examine other methods. I think all those are good. I think we need to direct staff. With regards to the examine other methods, I hope that we can specifically look at the specific plans and the landscaping requirement for the future growth areas. And I liked what the chief talked about briefly about that one program in Southern California that seems to be effective. It would be nice if we could get a little bit more information on that when it comes back to the council for the report. And I think that was it.
Thank you. All right, just a couple things here. I do want to thank everyone from the community that's taken the time to be here. I do think this was particularly good staff work, and that ought to be noted. I want to take the time also to thank the council for doing these study sessions, and the reason is most of us are working, as I occasionally like to point out, we're your neighbors. We want to do this. These study sessions are designed to educate, to listen, share what we think some of our challenges are, and to hear if there's some better ideas. Now that's the spirit of these. I'm going to continue to occasionally express my, you know, there's a time and place for headbutting, but these are really meant to be times of real engagement. So everyone should know that here, it may not be perfect, but it's in depth, it's thorough, we've got a lot out, and so I think there's great value in that. This council wants to accomplish that, and it does want it to move beyond just words. So with that, a couple of things. I want to note for the record, Councilmember McShane's, he on this issue, and each of us has our own passions, who sits up here as you all do. He isn't just showing up at council on this issue. Something personal interest, a lot of passion, a lot of commitment of time, and you know, when you're hands-on, you're really insightful, and that shows up. So that's a good thing for all of us. So I want to note that. I'm certainly supportive of the direction that's being suggested that we go tonight. This one kind of feels to me like take the task force concept. I would suggest broadening the base a little bit, because each part of the city, you know, I find it interesting to, and this is one of the things I really appreciate, the fact we're doing this with Republic. You know, we can break this out by district and go, gee, why is this one going up? Why is this one increasing? And so that probably also speaks to their, it's probably a little harder to, I note our friends in Monterey Park, they actually caught someone. We like that. But that may be harder to do in other parts of the city just because of the nature of the neighborhoods, how they're constructed, et cetera. So I like the task force concept. I would encourage broadening the base. And, you know, Tony, I think your comments are really well taken. We want to make sure we're not here to talk. We want to do some things. The task force is important. It is organic, but it does come side by side with this city's efforts to work differently. So we engaged Republic, and you know, I will tell you, in the 4 years I've been on council, to start seeing that information really specifically, being able to look at it, to advise the community of what some of our challenges are. You know, Mike, to hear your comments about maybe we ought to look at some of our requirements in terms of, you know, does fencing inadvertently lead to, you know, creating some opportunities? I will share quickly and anecdotally, I got a call from a friend of mine, immediately made a call to Doug, and they made the comment around the railroad that there's somebody that seems to be showing up, and it was across from their shop on Market Street, and they didn't like it. So I said, well, it may be an accessibility issue or a permission issue, and Doug said, yeah, it is, but we'll check. in there the next day, got the call, that's great, got the next call, they're back. So they are persistent, but we were able to go through that process of its accessibility and education and then the challenge. But I think what we did here tonight, and I think this is important, we heard the community is requesting and the council is comfortable with strengthening ordinances and trying to get more local control. And I agree on this checkbook issue, because it seems to me this is an area where we can, you know, really build in some accountability. It can hurt, but there's a sense of proportionality about it. That, you know, hey, if your kid or one of your relatives is involved in $500,000, you really just do need to know what somebody's up to. So I think we can do this with some meaning, some teeth, and some proportionality, which I think is a good combination. The one thing I want to say in defense of the DA, I don't think for a moment they're casual about this. They're going through the challenge of sifting through caseloads. And so the answer to that is recognize the challenges they have and try and move the control in tighter. And the civil route appears to allow that. So, you know, your motion or your thought on the ordinance may be exactly right. I think I would just simply add, having heard all this, I would ask the city attorney's office, you know, did they hear or do you recommend, you know, to go any additional steps further along those lines, because I think I really am hearing that is the will and the disposition of the community. The other thing is I would note in closing is that the council is in the process of also trying to figure out how to take advantage of the fact that there are folks willing to work for free, to volunteer their time, but as a city, we need to be in the business of creating enduring structures. And Sergio's right, you always want to capture neighborhood involvement in any design of your organization. On the other hand, you know, as I asked somebody here, I said, can you do me a favor and tell me exactly what you'll be doing in 10 years? Can I count on you? If we're in the business of enduring structures. So we do have to kind of find that medium. But we should note for the record that this council in its mid-year budget correction did authorize funds for part-time volunteers to help coordinate work with volunteers. So we think that's important. We want to move in that direction. The year the neighborhood was not meant to be window dressing. And on March 26th, spearheaded by the faith community, we will once again see Serve Day. And on April 2nd, everybody is involved in a terrific day of unity around the community. So, and the new director of Library and Community Services will be convening a Congress of the Neighborhoods to try and bring all the neighborhood groups together to discuss precisely these types of things. So we are trying to put some structure against this issue, and obviously graffiti is going to show up, and I do appreciate the perspective of the police chief. Wherever we can, we certainly want to look at technology as well. So I think we've accomplished what we wanted to try and accomplish tonight: to educate, to listen, to try and inform and be informed, and then come up with some additional concrete steps. So from my vantage point, a good meeting. And if any final comments from council before we take off, Jill?
Just real quickly, what I would like, was wondering if we could recommend to the educational subcommittee to talk with these high school districts about, somebody had brought this up, about using community service as to get rid of graffiti. So if that could go to educational subcommittee.
That would make sense. Good. All right. All right. I think we're adjourned. We're going to show up for city council next week. That is the 15th. And anyone is interested, I will be doing a State of the City at the Chinese Cultural Center on 1 California Street on Thursday at noon. So with that, see you soon.